So today, we're going to be talking about NAC eye drops, also known as N-acetylcarnosine eye drops, which you may have seen promoted online as a way to not only prevent, but even treat and reverse cataracts naturally, as a way to sort of avoid the need for cataract surgery. But you know, I never learned about this while I was in school, so I've been digging into the research, and I'll tell you, I've learned some cool stuff that I didn't know about. In fact, to better understand the research and if NAC eye drops actually work, I reached out and collaborated with Nick from the channel Physionic, who happens to have a PhD in molecular medicine. So I'm excited to share some of his thoughts and insights on it. But first, what are NAC eye drops and what do they do in our bodies?
NAC or N-acetylcarnosine, not to be confused with the ever-popular N-acetylcysteine, is a molecule that acts as an antioxidant in our cells. So beyond that, because many things act as antioxidants, NAC is also believed to inhibit glycation. What is that? Well, when our blood sugar rises for long periods of time, think something like prediabetes or diabetes, the various functional proteins that serve a role in and on our cells can become linked to sugar molecules called glycation. This is a spontaneous, so largely unwanted process because it inhibits proteins from being able to serve their function for the cell. If this happens in your eyes, it means that the cells of your eyes are then unable to adapt and function as needed for optimal function. The exact mechanism by which NAC stops glycation is still a bit up in the air, but it's possible that NAC acts as a decoy, where NAC is bound to sugar molecules instead of more important proteins. But probably more likely is the fact that NAC is an antioxidant, and it is believed that oxidation, or altering the functional protein structure, can make proteins more prone to glycation. Since NAC quenches these oxidizing molecules, fewer glycated proteins get produced. Frankly, while there's some evidence for that, as mentioned in this recent scientific review, the evidence still needs to be fleshed out.
So what Nick was mentioning there about NAC's ability to work as an antioxidant, but also its effects on glycation, I think are rather interesting, especially relating to cataracts inside the eye, as age-related cataracts or senile cataracts are largely believed to be due to oxidation over a lifetime. And people who happen to have higher amounts of blood sugar, such as in the case of diabetes, are also known to develop cataracts much faster. In fact, people with severely uncontrolled blood sugars can even develop a diabetic cataract inside the eye, which ironically kind of appears as a sugar cookie. So at least at face value, it appears that mechanistically, NAC eye drops could have an effect on cataract development. But do we have any evidence? Like, what does the science say, and is there any proof that this actually has an effect on cataract development or even reversing cataracts? Here's what Nick has to say.
So, yeah, we do have some evidence pointing to NAC's positive role in combating cataracts. In one study, which I really like the design because they had three groups of people all diagnosed with senile cataracts. One group was given nothing, so a typical control group. Another group was given a placebo, so a non-NAC substance. And the final group was, as you likely guessed, NAC eye drops at a 1% concentration. Now, ultimately, over 2 years, the researchers identified that 90% of those who use NAC drops experience at least some improvement in their eye acuity and glare sensitivity. In some cases, there were huge improvements, including reduced progression of cataracts. Now, I should caution that what we went over is just one study, but the gold standard review of studies called the Cochrane Review mentions that there are very few studies that have actually looked into NAC for cataracts, which makes our interpretation difficult because usually we'd like to see these studies replicated to be sure. Still, initial thoughts are this looks promising. Oddly enough, these studies are from over 20 years ago, so still waiting on more, and boy have we been waiting.
So after reading through the same studies, I also came to similar conclusions, that it appears that NAC eye drops may have an effect, but the research is severely lacking. In fact, I'll even add that I have some reservations about this particular study, as in the control group, as you dig into it, it appears that the control group was actually split. They told half of the people in the control to use phosphate buffered saline, where the other half they told to just do nothing. Don't use any eye drops at all, which I think really muddies the results quite a bit, as it introduces variability, and that kind of throws out the placebo-controlled aspect of the study, which is then compounded by the fact that it was a really small study. They only had 49 participants, 26 of which used the NAC eye drops, and that means that 13 of them used the phosphate-buffered saline, which ultimately reduces the statistical power of the study and generalizability. And I think this is important to point out because the improvements in visual acuity and glare that's reported with the NAC eye drops in this study, we also tend to see improvements in visual acuity and glare for people who just use eye drops in general, especially in an older population who oftentimes do also have dry eye disease. And the data sets in this study didn't analyze them independently. They instead just pooled them all and called them the control group. So again, I just wish this study was more solid around the use of eye drops in the control group. But there is one more thing about this research that Nick had to share.
Speaking of the studies on NAC and cataracts, another aspect to consider is the conflicts of interest for studies. Unfortunately, the two studies that have been done on NAC and cataracts come from the same research group, and that research group was industry funded. So we're stuck between some pretty good data and having to trust a single research group that's been funded by industry. It doesn't mean that the results aren't true, but it does leave one wanting for much more.
So then after reading all this research, I then asked Nick just his final thoughts on the subject.
In totality, I think we're talking about something that might work and might work quite well, but we're relying on potentially biased research. So I'd say the evidence leans in the direction of NAC working, but it doesn't lean strongly for the reasons that we went over. I will say these potentially biased studies mention no serious adverse effects from its use. So titrating it might be worth a shot, at least up to 2 years, which is the length of the studies assessed. However, if we're talking about antioxidants for the eyes, assuming that's the major mechanism for NAC, there are other more potent antioxidants like lutein and zeaxanthin that accumulate in your eyes. Unfortunately, while the evidence is quite strong for general eye care using these two molecules, the evidence is again weaker for specifically cataracts. They're also generally assessed as consumables, not eye drops. In short, I think NAC is a wary option, but just know that there isn't much reliable science behind it yet. But who knows? Maybe if we wait another 20 years, they'll feed us another study to scrutinize.
Now, before I share my final 2 cents about the use of NAC eye drops, I do want to just give a shout out and thank you to Nick from the channel Physionic. It's a channel that I've been following for some time and really do enjoy. And I think if you're somebody who likes to learn about nutrition, about supplementation, and the physiology of the human body, especially from an evidence and science-based perspective, he really does a fantastic job. I'll even include a link to some of my favorite videos of his down in the description below that like button for you if you want to check it out. And the final thing I wanted to add here about NAC eye drops is that while there are several brands of NAC eye drops on the internet and several health gurus who often promote them as a way to reverse and avoid cataract surgery, know that at this time they are not FDA approved here in the US, and even the eye drop safety search tool through the Dry Eye Foundation has flagged them for having kind of questionable ingredients and for other factors. So before anybody starts going out and trying these, I at least urge caution and always encourage you to talk to an eye care professional before, again, trying something that may be questionable. Otherwise, if you want to learn more about antioxidant supplementation that has really strong evidence to help the eyes, such as lutein and zeaxanthin that Nick mentioned, you can just check out some of the next videos that are coming up here to the side where we've covered more deeply on that topic. Thanks so much for watching. Dr. Allen here. Hope you learned something new, and we'll see you in that next video.